5 years ago, there were more than a billion people in the world without energy. Now, actually, that's reduced to about 800 million, and that's because of remote solar. My name is Professor Henry Snaith, and I'm the co-founder and chief scientific officer at Oxford PV. I founded Oxford PV from the work I was doing in the university. We discovered these perovskite materials that produce power at a much higher efficiency than any other material we'd looked at. When we started looking at this material, it was delivering over 10% efficiency, which was already competitive with some commercial PV products. That's risen up to over 25% efficiency just as a single absorber layer. We can actually combine it with silicon by making a so-called tandem device. And if you could make an infinite number of junctions, you could get up to around 83% efficiency. Since our initial discoveries in 2012, the whole world has woken up to perovskites, and there's probably 10,000 researchers across the world in all the different institutions working on these materials. It's the first major change to standard PV since the silicon cell was first discovered in the 1950s. The prospect for long-term advancement of getting close to 100% efficiency is actually feasible.
And the perovskite layers are extremely thin, less than 1 micrometer in thickness, which is a 40th of the thickness of our human hair on the top there.
The module is actually a relatively small fraction of the overall deployment cost. Most of the cost is in the land, it's in the metal frames to hold the modules, which means that if you want to make solar cheaper, if you just keep driving down the cost of the module, there's diminishing returns. Whereas if you could double the power output for the module for the same price, you would halve the cost straight away.
These go through all sorts of harsh environmental stress tests to make sure that the fundamental stability of the cells and materials inside is going to last for the 25 years required for real world operation.
Farming amounts to about half our land use. For the UK, if we needed to produce all our power from photovoltaics, we'd need about 2% of our land at 20% efficient modules, which are the sort of best modules of today. Of course, if that goes up to 40% efficiency, then you need only 1% of our land. So compared to how much land we need for feeding ourselves, it's a very small fraction.
This is a solar simulator. It does what it says on the tin, it simulates sunlight. This is so that we can test our cells in the lab for characterizing their efficiency and performance without having to wait for a sunny day.
In Brandenburg, Germany, Oxford PV is building its first volume factory. Opening in 2021, the facility will initially have a capacity of 125 megawatts, with a target capacity of over a gigawatt by 2024.
The factory that we're building here that opens next year and in 2021 actually is only big enough to produce power for about 36,000 homes. Our plans are to build much larger factories in the future so that we can build at the scale that's required to have an impact on the energy generation for the world. I'm Chris Case, and I'm the Chief Technology Officer at Oxford PV. Oxford PV's perovskite technology is the most significant solar technology in 65 years. It's going to make energy cheaper. And cheaper energy means more access of energy to everyone. Cheaper energy means a faster adoption and move to an all-electric future. An all-electric future is the only way to save this planet.
Each one of these is a solar cell, so actually you can peek in and see the solar cells, they come in stacks, 200 at a time, being transferred into the tool that produces this very thin coating. The rate is roughly 1 every 2 seconds, about 2,400 solar cells per hour. Here is one of the films that we produce. It's being tested on a piece of glass, and we shine a laser through it so we can measure its characteristics. Normally that film would be put on one of these silicon solar cells and would make the high-performing perovskite solar cell.
Change is not happening fast enough to arrest climate change. The targets are very aggressive, but 50% of energy generated by photovoltaics by 2050 is simply not fast enough. We do need to do something to move solar cells and solar energy adoption faster. And this technology from Oxford PV is one of those ways to do that.
We need to act now. We need to embrace new technologies like perovskite and drive them forward at a pace that has to have an urgency to it.
in all electric future is amazingly exciting because of the changes that it can do for the world. I mean, just think, when electricity becomes so inexpensive, you do things that were unimaginable before.
Ultimately, if perovskites remain the most efficient, easiest to process semiconductor material for photovoltaics, then there's absolutely no reason why they can't produce most of our global power demand.
Remember, Thomas Edison had this very famous quote, you know, I place my bet on the sun and solar energy. I just only hope we don't wait until oil and coal run out before we tackle it.